Froggy Plays Soccer by Jonathan London and illustrated by Frank Remkiewicz. This book is copyright by Jonathan London and Frank Remkiewicz, and it's published by Scholastic, Inc. Ink. Froggy couldn't sleep. Yeah, neither could he. He looked out the window. The full moon was rising. It looked like a soccer ball. Yeah, it did. Look at that.
Tomorrow's the big game,
he said out loud.
If we beat the wild things, we win the city cup.
The wild things? In the morning, Froggy was bursting to go. He pulled on his underwear. Zap! Tugged on his soccer shorts. Zeep! What is zeep? That's not a sound effect. That is not an onomatopoeia. Snapped on his shin guards. Snap. It looks like he accidentally stepped on a lizard. Now it's flat. Wiggled on his soccer shirt. Zlim. These are not sound effects. Pulled on his soccer socks. Zoop. Do frogs have feet like that? And put on his cleats. Zoop, zoop.
Yaw. Ready. Give me a hug.
Froggy! Called his father. Froggy's father was the assistant coach. He's eating a bowl of flies.
What?
How is Froggy doing that with his head? His body is forward and he turned it all the way around. He would snap his neck.
Let's go. We'll be late for the game.
Froggy flopped outside. Flop, flop, flop.
Remember, said Froggy's dad, only the goalie can catch the ball. And you're not the goalie. That's not your job. Yeah, and you don't have a job either. That's why we're riding this bike instead of a car. You're totally grounded. Now repeat after me. Head it, boot it, knee it, shoot it. But don't use your hands.
He's like yelling him off the bike. Barely hanging on. And Froggy saying,
head it, pff, oh, boot it, caw, knee it, shoot it, but don't use your hands.
All the way to the soccer field.
Hey guys!
At the soccer field, the coach, Max's mother, said,
we're a team! We're the dream team!
Hooray!
Screamed the dream team. What is that supposed to be? Is that a turtle without his shell? That just looks weird. Soon, the game was on! Froggy was doing cartwheels. Wow. Froggy was picking daisies.
Oh, this one would look good.
Froggy was picking his nose. It hit him right in the belly. Ball bounced off his chest. He gave a mighty kick.
Yaw!
And missed the ball. Pathetic. This is what I would be doing. But Max trashed it and passed it to BJ, who slammed it right into the net. Go! Man, you scared this kid so much he poop farted. It was 1-0, Dream Team.
Yeah!
Put that finger away. That's not good sportsmanship. Again, the two teams faced off. The whistle blew. The Dream Team charged down the field toward the wild things. Froggy was tying his shoe. Froggy, you're supposed to do that before the play starts. Don't you know anything about golf?
What? Oh.
Froggy's dad was yelling,
defense! Defense!
The ball hit Froggy in the head and knocked him down. He was great at defense. And that, kids, is called sarcasm. At halftime, the Dream Team held the lead.
Now remember,
said Froggy's dad, and they all chanted together.
Head it, boot it, knee it, shoot it,
but don't use your hands.
The whistle blew, and the second half started. A fly circled by. Does this book have ADD?
Froggy,
called the coach.
What?
Keep your eye on the...
The ball smacked him in the eye.
Oh, the heck.
Froggy was mad now. The wild things were stampeding. And Matthew, the Dream Team's goalkeeper, was chasing the ball. Now the goal was unguarded. This was Froggy's chance. He leapfrogged over Travis. He leapfrogged over Matthew. He leapfrogged over the wild things forward, who was firing the ball. I think something just cracked in my neck. This kid is a wild freak. And what a save! Froggy caught it right before the net. But he'd used his hands like he wasn't supposed to.
Oops.
cried Froggy, looking more red in the face than green. He looked so silly. The dream team laughed. But not for long. The penalty for using his hands was a free kick at the goal for the Wild Things. The Wild Things' star forward kicked.
Yeah.
And scored! Now it was a tied game. Man, even this thing could turn his head all the way around. Froggy, why didn't you jump that time? Just use your head. But it wasn't over yet. And when there was 1 minute left, the crowd went crazy. The clock was ticking. The ball was coming right toward Froggy.
Oh, yeah. I'm gonna eat it. Oh, don't touch me, ball. Froggy!
Yelled his dad.
What?
But Froggy knew what to do. He jammed his hands in his armpits. He stuffed them in his pockets.
Ew.
He did little tippy toes. He stuck them in his mouth. Ew, what? Why would you stick them under your armpits and then put them in your mouth? Then he power kicked the ball so far down the field that it bounced over the goalie's head. Smack into the goal.
Yes!
That hurt my ears. This kid stinks. He was jet propelled upwards with his fart power. The dream team had won the city cup. They shouted and danced, and Froggy sang,
"Hurt it, boot it, knee it, shoot it, but don't use your hands."
Ugh, my brain hurts.
Except to slap high fives. Good job, you, yeah. What was your name? You know, good friend of mine. Yeah.
Max. My name's Max.
Yeah, I knew that. Totally.
All right, this is really awkward now.
Okay, we'll pull away on the count of three. One, two, three. You didn't pull away.
You didn't either.
Stop touching my hand.
The end. If you enjoyed this video, go ahead and leave a like. In other words, hit the thumbs up. That's the like. And if you want to see more of our videos, go ahead and subscribe. And don't forget to hit the bell. It'll tell you when more of our videos come out. Thank you for watching, and we'll see you in the next reading.